Welcome to Gembe blog. In this video we are going to discuss about how to create toolbar using JToolbar class. What is the purpose of JToolbar? It is used to implement toolbar. Toolbar is nothing but it's a container that holds commonly used control so that you can able to retrieve that control in a fast manner. So when you talk about the hierarchy, JToolbar belongs to javax.swing.jtoolbar package, which has been derived from J component package. Now we'll start with step by step procedure to create toolbar. Now before we enter into creating the toolbar, we'll discuss about the basic code to perform this operation. First you have to include the necessary package, and then you have to define a public class. So inside the class you have to define a constructors. Inside the constructors, we have included the code to create a frame and display it on the screen. So inside the main, you have to call the constructors. Now we'll start with creation of toolbar using JToolbar class. So the first constructor, it will not receive any argument. So JToolbar DB equal to new JToolbar. So once we created it, you have to add this toolbar into the frame. So f dot add of toolbar. Okay, now we will check. Now you could see the small container has been added into the toolbar. Now we have to populate the component into this so that you can able to see the toolbar clearly. So for this we are going to use add method. So add method is used to add the controls into the toolbar. So for this, first I am going to create the button, new J button. We are going to pass the image icon here. So new image icon. So since we are going to create this button for bold option, so we are going to pass the b.jpg image. So once it is created, we have to add this into the toolbar. So db.add of vivo. So just creating the object and then passing the object as an argument into the add method. So second way, you can able to directly create the object dynamically. So j button of new image icon, so I dot jpeg. So these are the two ways you can able to populate your toolbar with the components. Now you could see the toolbar contains two controls, B button and the I button. Here the toolbar has been arranged horizontally. Now if you want to change the alignment of the controls in the toolbar, means you can able to do it using the second constructors. It will receive how, either we are going to perform the vertical alignment or horizontal alignment. The default alignment is horizontal alignment. Now you have to going to change it to vertical alignment. Toolbar dot vertical. Now you could see all the controls in the toolbar has been aligned vertically. Next we will see how to add the separators between the components. Again we are going to do it horizontal alignment. Now we are going to add db.add separator. Now you could see the separator has been added between the two buttons. So you can also provide the dimension value for the separators. Dimension 100 cross 100. You could see the space between the two components has been increased to 100 cross 100. Next, we are going to extract the components at the particular index. Since we have added the components directly, this will not be considered for counting the components. For this, we are going to change into button component. First, we will create the button component. IO button. So we are passing I. Once we created, we are going to add it into the containers. Now we are going to extract the components which is available at the index value. System dot out dot println db dot get component at index 1. We will see what will happen. So here it is, which component is available at the index 1? Separators. So all the details with respect to the separators has been retrieved and it will be displayed it. Now if you want to extract the class of that particular component, means use get class to extract the class that is available at that particular index. So you could see the class name of the particular component will be extracted. Next, how to get the index value of the particular component? Now we are going to pass the get component index of the particular object BO. Now we are going to extract the index of the component BO. You could see the index value of the component BO is 0. So it is extracted and displayed. Now you are going to make your toolbar property, floatable property, as true or false. Now what is mean by floatable property? So first we will take it. You could see the dotted lines in the toolbar. If this is available, means I can say that toolbar is floatable. Floatable means I can able to move my toolbar anywhere. Suppose if you want to fix it, you can move and drag it. So that is floatable. You can able to move your toolbars anywhere. So if you don't want your toolbar to be floatable, means okay, you can able to set the property of floatable property using set floatable. So db dot set floatable. Initially it is true. So if you don't want, means you have to set it to false. Is floatable to ensure that whether the floatable property has been set for particular toolbar or not. So for this, system dot out dot println db dot is floatable will return whether the floatable property has been set or not. Now you can notice that the dotted lines is not appears on the toolbar. If that is the case, means I can't able to move the toolbar further. Now since it is not floatable, it returns false. Next we will discuss about set rollover method. So if you want to set the rollover state of the toolbar, that means whenever the mouse is moved over the particular control has to be highlighted. So if for this, you have to use set rollover method. Set rollover, so we are going to set it to, first it will be false. Then if you want to ensure whether the rollover property has been set, how to use is rollover. Now you could see when the mouse is moved over the particular control is not highlighted and also it returns false since the rollover property has set to false. Now we are going to set it to true. So default is true. Now you could see when the mouse is moved over the particular control, you could see the particular control is highlighted. Similarly for this J button also. Thank you.